I'm Misa Ramirez, and we are here at Books on the House talking with Barbara DeRobertis, who is the author of the Animal Antics from A to Z book series with Kane Press. Welcome, Barbara.
Thank you very much, Misa.
So good to have you here, and I would love for you to start by telling us about the Animal Antics book series.
The Animal Antics A to Z are a series of books that were written really for several reasons. First of all, they're wonderfully fun stories, and I wrote them because I wanted children to love reading and hearing these stories. There's one for every letter of the alphabet, and they address the issue of phonemic awareness, which is a pre-reading skill that is focused on primarily in preschool, kindergarten, first grade. And the phonemic awareness component is critical in helping kids learn to identify a specific letter sound at the beginning, the middle, and the end of a word. And so there are lots and lots of repetitions of a particular phoneme or letter sound in each of the books. For example, Alexander Anteater's Amazing Act has tons of words that have both the short A and the long A sound of the word. Bobby Baboon's Banana Bebop has lots of words that have that B phoneme at the beginning, middle, and end of words. And so the books are going to carry with them a lot of additional activities and also online websites that are going to offer parents, teachers, kids the opportunity to have even more activities, plus a recipe for every book. All the things online are free, are downloadable, and reproducible, so you have lots of materials and games and so forth that can be used in a variety of settings. And we're hoping that kids will really enjoy that learning part of the series as well. I worked with the kindergarten teachers at our school who are wonderful, wonderful teachers, and they're very excited about these books. They tested the stories to be sure that the kids liked them as much as I hoped they would. They have tried a lot of the activities, and they're excited about the potential for focusing on one book with the activities over the course of a week, and I think that would be great.
And so they're geared for teachers and parents working with their children in homeschooling, but also they're very highly engaging for the kids themselves.
Yes, I'm pleased with how much the kids just plain like the stories. And I went down to our elementary school last week and read the first four books. There are four books that are currently released. In 2 weeks, there will be another six books. So right now, I can show you the four books that we have. I read each morning in the library one of these books, and I had kids anywhere from kindergarten through fourth grade. And the kids all really responded so happily to the books, and we talked a lot about them, and I think they genuinely liked them. So we started with our great Alexander Anteater, and then we read Bobby Baboon. And I want to mention that the illustrator for these books, R.W. Alley, is a master illustrator, and he has captured these characters to a T. He puts so much life and humor and emotion and tenderness into the illustrations, and so I'm just delighted with these books and his work.
Did you work together with him in what your vision was?
He really gets it. I have laughed over and over again. He's in New York, I'm in Washington State, and we're geographically far apart, but we work together through the publisher and my editor. And his illustrations come in, and I'm always so thrilled. There's only one time when I had to laugh when the picture he saw in his head wasn't what I had envisioned when I was telling the story. And since you live in Texas, you'll appreciate this. In this book, or Bobby Baboon, actually. Mm-hmm. In Bobby Baboon, there is a character called named Buster Buffalo. And Buster Buffalo is a bit of a bully. And he bangs his boots on the ground. And in my mind, I'm thinking cowboy boots. Uh-huh. But when the illustrations came in, my New York illustrator had envisioned hiking boots.
Oh.
I laughed because I thought, well, that's good. That's just fine. And then the fourth one that I have right now is Dilly Dog's Dizzy Dancing. And the next six books are about Eddie Elephant and Francis Frog and Gertie Gorilla and Hannah Hippo and Izzy Impala and Jeremy Jackrabbit are all going to be out in 2 weeks.
Wow. And then, so what's the time frame for the remainder of the series?
The remainder of the series will be out by, I think they're hoping, the summer of 2011, ready in time for the 2011-2012 school year.
Okay.
And the thing that I'm also tickled with is that these books are not just for kids learning letter sounds. After I finished reading, the kids were eager to check out the books. They wanted to be able to check them out so they could read them themselves. So once kids have mastered the basics of reading, they'll be able to read these books themselves. So I think they'll be very entertaining books that kids will get a lot of pleasure out of reading on their own.
And so can you tell me some of the animals for the more obscure letters of the alphabet that are not so used?
Well, you know, as I was going through the alphabet, I realized there are certain letters of the alphabet for which there are not many animals. And so I did some really extensive Googling online to try to come up with some interesting animals. One that was a particular challenge was you. And I found this wonderful animal that I had not been familiar with before, the unca. And it's actually called the agile unca. And it's a wonderful, beautiful animal, absolutely gorgeous. It's a gibbon. And Umma Unca has become the most adorable character in this series. Another one that was very tricky to find was the N. And in most animal alphabet books, I was a librarian, so I'm very familiar with all of these alphabet books. You usually see a newt, but I didn't think that was as much fun as a nandu, which is a South American rhea, like the ostrich or the emu. And Nina Nandu is a terrific character.
Well,
and
I think that's really neat because the kids are learning about animals that they would not otherwise have exposure to. So the books are very layered in that respect.
Let me show you one other thing. I thought after coming up with all these animals, the kids are going to want information about the real animals. So one of the things that we've done, and I'll just show you in this book, is there's a blurb at the on the very back page about the real animal. And so this tells kids what the real animal looks like and gives them some interesting fun facts about that animal. And something else I can show you while I've got the book open is at the back of the book there are also activities, a look back activity for phonemic awareness, and then a game, and then this reference to the website where you'll find things like this. These are the activities for Bobby Baboon. Another game, and then another activity, and some downloadable materials with bananas so that you can use those for your game, and a recipe for Bobby Baboon's blueberry banana smoothies. So,
did you develop all of the activities yourself, or did you have a team?
Actually, I did them, but with the consultation of the reading coach and the kindergarten teachers at our school.
Wow.
I'll run everything by them because they are really astute when it comes to things like that.
But you're a former teacher, so you have that that practical experience of what works in a classroom, too, and what parents need and what kids need.
That's right, because I just retired after 31 years of teaching, and I taught preschool, kindergarten, first grade, second grade, third grade, seventh grade, eighth grade, and then for the last 19 years, I was the librarian here in Kashmir. I taught before we moved to Kashmir, but here I taught 31 years, so I've had a wonderful, wonderful time in the classroom. And I've had a lot of training in reading and have done a lot of research. So it's been a lot of fun working on these books. I'm proud of them, and I just get so tickled every time I look at them now.
Well, I think they look fabulous, and wish you the best of luck with the release of the series. I'll be picking them up for my kids and my teacher, my son's first grade teacher. But best of luck, and thank you for being here on Books on the House.
Thank you very much, Nisa.